Hello YouTube, this is our good friend the iMac G4. It's still up and running. It's been part of my setup for the past couple weeks now, and I've been using it a little bit, and a couple days ago I actually decided to do some upgrades. As you might remember, this thing only has a CDRW drive, 640 megs of RAM, and a 40 gig hard drive. Well, I changed a couple things. I upgraded RAM. It's now running with 1 gigabyte. Let's see here. I'm gonna move you a little bit closer to the screen now because everything else I'm gonna tell is going to be related to the display as well. So there we go. Still running macOS 9.2. Built-in memory is now set to 1 gigabyte, which is very nice. There we go. I'm trying to stabilize the image a little bit, but nope, can't straighten it out for you, so you OCD people have to deal with this. But yeah, we have 1 gigabyte of RAM now, and one thing that's also very, very convenient, there we go, we now have a DVD drive. It's a DVD-ROM, so it will only read DVDs. It won't write CDs or DVDs, but that's just fine in my opinion. I'm just very glad that it actually finally works and I can use DVDs. Because it was running Panther before, OS 10 Panther. I decided to upgrade it to Tiger. And, well, I really just did a clean install of Tiger, that's what I was actually going to say, but... But yeah, I also upgraded the hard drive in here, because, the optical drive and the hard drive are installed in the same cage, stored in this, you know, in the spherical housing here. Pretty much the hard drive is on top, and underneath it is the optical drive. And then the CPU is down, you know, all the way on here in this, this bottom part here. Very interesting machines to work on. The weirdest thing that I discovered is that they use one regular dual inline memory module for desktops and one SODIMM, you know, laptop memory. So it has both laptop memory and desktop memory in the same machine. This thing only takes SD RAM because this is the original model from 2002. But yeah, we can take two 512 megabyte modules, of which the 512 megabyte module for the SODIMM, you know, the laptop memory, is quite a bit harder to find. But luckily this machine actually came with the 512 meg SODIMM pre-installed instead of the regular desktop memory. Probably because the SODIMM is easier to add, because you need to get to the logic board in order to replace the desktop memory chip. And you don't for the laptop chip and the airport card. Airport card's still in the mail, I will do a video on that and we'll install that live on video because now we know how to open this thing up. That's why I didn't record the upgrade process for this upgrade. But yeah, we now have a hard drive that is 80 gigs in size. Decided to split it in two partitions, as you can see here. They're both equally sized, about 40 gigs each. So, nothing real special there. And yeah, DVD-ROM drive now instead of CD-ROM slash CD-RW drive. It's a regular TSST Corp. Or Toshiba Samsung storage technology, whatever you want to call it. And yeah, so it's still running OS 9. This is the OS 9 Lives distribution that has all of the latest patches and updates that the OS 9 operating system needs. So you have the latest Carbon Lib, you have the latest QuickTime version, latest updates. So you have 9.2.2, stuff like that. Runs very nicely on this 700 MHz G4. I would imagine it would, because it runs fine on a 500 MHz G3, so... Now let's boot into OS 10 Tiger to see how that runs. One thing that I have noticed is that this machine feels much speedier on this hard drive than it did on the 40GB Mac Store. That was actually originally in it. But yeah, I've had this 80GB Seagate for a while now, and it's always been very, very fast. I've put it in many IDE systems, and it's been running like a champ. By the way, if the screen is flickering, and I'm sorry about that, but I think this panel uses a very interesting refresh rate, and this camera, of course, only records 30 FPS, so there's no match there. So that's a little detail. But yeah, I'll actually get the original hard drive, I'll show it to you. Here we have it. This is the original hard drive in Mac Store 40 gig with the Apple logo, of course. This still has the original install of OS X Panther and the OS 9 image on it as well. I'll be keeping this around for a while. I'll just put this on a shelf. We are actually going to, be needing that at some point. If this hard drive decides to fail, then I can put that back in, or I'll probably use an adapter like IDE to SD card or something like that. So there we go, 700 megahertz PowerPC G4 with a gig of RAM, running OS 10.4.11. Runs very, very nicely, I have to admit. Also installed the heaviest PowerPC program out there, which is Microsoft Word 2008. So let's see how long that takes to load. I remember this took about, I don't know, 20 to 30 seconds on my PowerBook G4. Even after installing the SSD, it was still a good 15-20 seconds. And this is no different. This is very heavy software. But you know, if you need a little bit of a backup machine to open up your .docx files, you really, really need Office 2008, because I don't think Microsoft actually did a compatibility pack for Office 2004 like they did with 2003 and Windows. So that's a bit interesting there. But yeah, this is definitely the slowest software on the PowerPC Mac, for sure. This even ran like crap on Intel, so Office 2007 on Windows was definitely a much better suite than the 2008 for Mac was. But yeah, this is one of the rare versions that's actually in Dutch, so which is convenient for me. I know my way around English just fine, but there's just something about your first language that can be beaten by anything. It's just a sheer convenience, really. So yeah, don't really have a lot of software on here now. But it is running just fine. Here's Unreal Tournament. For some reason, games really don't want to run on this GeForce 2. Oops, let's suffer a bit. On the GeForce 2 MX, like, at all. I mean, on OS 9, I installed Quake 3 Arena and Return to Castle Wolfenstein. And they both ran absolutely horribly, even on the lowest settings. I don't know what's up with that. I mean, the GeForce 2 MX is definitely capable of more than just that, even at 640x480. I mean, my Power Mac G4 that I used to have with the dual 450 MHz and the Rage 128 did infinitely better in those games. At least I could run them at high settings, no problem. And the GeForce 2 MX is definitely faster than a Rage 128, so I don't know what's the problem there, but yeah, you know, it's a GeForce 2 MX, HEP bus, 32 megs of VRAM. Supports Quartz Extreme, so I would figure that it would work better than it does, but oh well, I can keep using this for regular tasks like desktop stuff, no problem. And I'll have to figure out what's the deal with the video problem. Maybe it needs some sort of updated drivers or anything. I'm not sure. OS 9 is the latest driver and it still runs like crap, and OS 10 is even worse, so I have no idea. In my recollection, they used to run better when I first got this machine with the older hard drive and less RAM, but you know, this thing uses its you know, dedicated VRAM, so there's just no way that that actually has any influence, so then again, I don't know for sure. What I do know for sure is that this iMac G4, aside from the graphics part, is running absolutely perfectly on OS X Tiger and OS 9.2.2. I really love using this machine. I just wish that I had a better keyboard for it, none of this rubber dome crap. So I'll probably use my PS2 to USB adapter on it if I need to get some typing done for the retro feel. But other than that, I think this is the end of the video. Hope you enjoyed this video on the upgrades on my iMac G4. Once the AirPort card is in, I will do a video on how to install that. And I will test out the AirPort capabilities of the machine. And I really don't think I'll open it up anytime soon after that. Maybe if I'm actually going to do the SD card solid state conversion on it, but that's still up in the air right now. Hope you enjoyed this video. I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.